A question I get asked quite a lot is where's the best place to store your images or photos online? As many people want to be able to upload their photos online so they can view them on other computers or maybe on their mobile phone when out and about. When I go over to family's house, they want to share their photos of their holiday. And you may not be able to have store all your photos on your phone due to the lack of space. And plus, if you have too many phone images on your phone, then you're not going to be able to store applications or your email or whatever you use your phone for or games. So people often want to be able to store their photos online. This is a great way to store your photos, but I do stress that you should always store your information or data in more than three places. So I will store my photos on my external hard drive, the one that's over here, which you can't see. Maybe on my computer with on my Mac in iPhoto, and then I'll store them on a online service. So I'm making sure I've got my data in three places. So any important photos I might put on a disk as well. So I will have links to my recommended hard drives in my blog. Link will be below this video. And I also will have a link to all of these services and a bit about them over at my blog. So you can go ahead and choose which one you wish to use. Just go ahead and go through a quick reason of using each of the services. The service I use right now is Picasa. The reason why I use this is because I do use a lot of Google products right now. And I'm quite keen Google Plus user, and I use Gmail a lot, I like to keep my space all in one place. And I think Google currently have 20 gigabytes worth of space for $5 a year, which is really cheap. I can see this going up eventually, but it should be more competitive with the rest of the company's offerings. But for now, it's a good alternative. $5 a year for 20 gigabytes, you can't go wrong. And I can now use that space on my email and all the other features I use of Google services. And you've got a great editor, and you can download the Picasa program, which lets you upload the photos and store them in albums, so you can go to a family member's house and see the photos in your album. And that is linked with Google Plus. You can also share particular photos with particular people on Google Plus, as well as viewing it in a link of an album. So you can upload a photo and hide a specific photo. Another great alternative to Picasa, but a bit more expensive, but been going a little longer, is PhotoBucket. You do get a free version of this on 1 gigabyte. And with Picasa, if you're not a heavy Gmail user, you do get about 2 gigabytes free, I believe, on Picasa. But then this does use all of Google services. As you start using Google Plus more, I think Photos, you may find you need to upgrade your plan. But PhotoBucket lets you edit and share photos and hide photos and share them with certain friends. But as most people have a Google account at some point, Picasa is great. And then you've got Flickr, which is used by Yahoo, or owned by Yahoo. You can sign in your Google account or Facebook. This could be a good feature if you want to sign in with only one account, so you need your Facebook account. You do start off with a little bit of space, I believe about 2 gigabytes worth of space. And you can get unlimited storage on Flickr for about $24 a year, I believe. And as owned by Yahoo, it's not going to go anywhere fast, so it could be a great choice. But both Flickr and Picasa or Google let you take your data with you, so if their servers were closing down, you can quickly edit and move the photos quickly. So they're great storage. And if you're not interested in having albums and sharing albums with friends and family, two servers I would recommend would be Boxy.net or Box.com, as it should redirect to now, but I will put a link below where the right version of this is, and Dropbox. These are both services that let you have the files on your computer, phone, and at the moment on Box.com, you can get 50 gigabytes of storage for free on your iOS and Android device. This lets you store more than photos. Lets you store movies and everything on here, but it does have a file size limit of 2 gigabytes or a gigabyte, I think, of each file that can be uploaded. Then, of course, you've got Dropbox, which will let you store and sync your files everywhere. So if you're not interested in albums, which these three offer you, then these two might be a good alternative, as you can store them on your computer, and you can obviously view them on your computer, and you can get Dropbox on your phone. And I believe the same, and you can with Boxy.com. Both of these let you view the photos on your phone online, so you don't have to have them stored on your phone, but you can still access them online. But my choice is definitely Picasa. So I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget, you can view the blog post below. And don't forget, if you have questions, you can ask them at mdrtech.co.uk/answers. Hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time.